Welcome to How to Catch Herobrine in Minecraft 1.4. My name is Chubzilla, and this is how to summon or obtain, if you will, Herobrine. Around me you'll see my house, and I'll be going through all the essentials that you'll need to find him. And I'll be going over some more stuff at the end of the video. So, first things first, there are some little requirements that you'll need. That will have changed from last time if you'd watched my previous videos. Firstly, there's no special house requirements, it's just basic. You know, you have a house that you live in with a bed. That's basically just the requirements. All these are just fancy little things, the upstairs, the windows, the flowers. It's just a basic house. There's a zombie there. Another requirement is that you have been to the Nether. I will just go through here to show you I've been to the Nether. Yep. Lovely instantaneous Nether travel there. That's very interesting. And you may notice this little contraption up here. I'll get to that in a minute actually. Another requirement is that you have at least one beacon in the world. I've put I have 5 beacons around, but you only need one. You don't have to activate it or anything. You can have steel, diamond, gold, whatever you need. I just use diamond because that's the first thing I found in creative mode. And that's all you need. What else is there? You will need to be playing on at least normal difficulty. So, those are all the requirements that you need. And there's a little actual trigger this time to summon them. As before, it was just like a random occurrence, you might spawn in the dark cave, or whatever. But no, this time it is an actual summoning thing. And to do this, I forgot to set this up.
One moment.
The little trigger that you need to do to summon him is you must drop 4 anvils. It could be from any height, but you know, I like a big long distance just because you can drop them one at a time. They don't all have to be at the same time. They could just be over the course of the whole game. You could leave them. Basically, you just let them fall like this. You don't need the marks. I just put them there for cool. They hit the ground. Oh, that one's not damaged. Nice little bug there. They hit the ground, and the 1, 2, 3, 4 hitting the ground signifies like the calling of Herobrine. Now, this doesn't summon him instantly, not quite. It spawns him out when it's night time. I think it's precisely in the middle of the night. I'm not quite sure when exactly. So let's say I was standing in this red bit here. You'd go 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 20, 30. So we would spawn between about here, from down there, from a range of about, I don't know, here, roughly, and that'd be in a big circle all the way around. So you couldn't spawn exactly within your range, but yeah, he would spawn. And then when he does spawn, he would come at you and try to kill you, destroying whatever blocks may be in his path to get to you. One thing I did forget to mention was that there is a reason I haven't summoned him here as proof, and I have gone over it in the last 2 videos, but it is not everyone watches all of the videos, and that's because Herobrine is a very scary man. He is not quite as powerful as they once made him in 1.3.5, and no, it was just 1.3 and 1.25. He was a very scary character. He could quite literally burn your computer from the inside. He would cause it to, the Minecraft itself, to perform to such level it would overheat the CPU and cause your computer to catch fire or possibly explode, which is why I didn't have him appear in the last videos. But this time he's not quite that powerful, but he is still relatively strong. Not destroying strong, because you know, if the computer exploded and it got in someone's eye or something and they died, then you know, Mojang could be sued quite heavily. But no, this time He's not quite as powerful, but it is just strong inconveniences, like deleting all text files off the computer, which I don't really want to happen. So yeah, I will say this, don't try this at home. You can if you want. You know, this is just a strictly informative video on how to summon him if you wanted to. Of course, you don't have to. There's no obligation to do so whatsoever. It's quite a nice jungle. I know in my last two videos I did go over on how to kill him as well, and I have not done that this time. It's because I haven't quite figured out how yet. But when I do, I will let you guys know with another video. So, you know, if you want to subscribe to me so you get that video, or just keep checking my channel, I don't really mind which. And yeah, if you enjoyed how to find Herobrine, please leave a like. So yeah, thank you for watching. This has been Chubzilla 100, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.